Hello, BookTube Nation. I'm Sam here again with Abernabe Books. And today, as you can see, we're in a little bit of a different spot, same room, but I wanted to get up here to my middle grade shelf. I have a couple, but I kind of rearranged some things. My books are organized by alphabetical order, but they're by author's last name, but they're also in like categories. So I have like middle grade, but then I also have like retellings and like fairy tale retellings. And so sometimes there are some middle grades in that. I also have like a sci-fi area and a fantasy area. So depending on how I was feeling when I did my shelves, some middle grade books could end up throughout my house. But I've reorganized the shelf. I have everything on here that I think I'm gonna be interested in reading. But truth, I've been really a mood reader lately, so that's why I have a lot of books here to talk about today. Also, one day I've been tagged in a lot of really lovely tags, and I'm sorry, I'm awful about tags. I do mark them all down when I've been tagged, and I get really excited, and then I have a hard time getting to them. But one day I will do a tag that is like all about your shelves and how many books you have and how many shelves you have. If you're interested in people that have way too many books, I would be one of those people. I definitely have in the 4 digits, so probably close to 2,000, maybe more. I have a lot. I have an entire room dedicated to my books is my library that we're in right now. I also have books in my lounge and I have books in my bedroom. So I've been collecting for many years. I'm very grateful. I'm very spoiled. So yes, but if any of that interests you, maybe one day I'll show you all of them. So this is the bottom of like my middle grade shelves, and I kind of cleared away about 3/4 of this to fit the books that I'm interested in for middle grade March. But like I said, I've been really mood reading lately, so I'm gonna reserve the right to pull in anything. I even have some more books on order. I'll put a picture up here. I've ordered Frostheart, and that's by Jamie Littler, and I hope to have that before the end of middle grade March. But as we all know, things are kind of hectic right now, so who knows when it will actually get here. I've also ordered some books too, just I think books, second book in some series. I'll let you know when we get to those, which ones I have on order as well. I'm really excited. Some of these are new, some of these I picked up recently, and I'll let you know if that's the case. I love this readathon. Thank you, ladies, for hosting. I've been on YouTube for a while, and I don't always get the chance to like comment and like form relationships. I'm a stay-at-home mom, and a lot of times when I get a chance to watch videos, I watch them on my television, so I can't like comment on there. You know, I would like to get more involved in the community, obviously. My channel has been going for a while now. I love this readathon. I always get excited. I actually find that even though I host like a 10-day readathon twice a year, I love month-long readathons. They're some of my favorite. I find that for my reading and my lifestyle, they work really well. The readathon I mentioned is a fairy tale-a-thon, and I'll link my fairy tale folder playlist below that I have, so you can check that out if you want. We don't have another one currently scheduled right now, but I imagine there will be one sometime during the year of 2021, if not two. Some years we do two. So our hosts, of course, are Krista at Books and Jams and Katie at Life Between Words. And then this year, Amanda from The Curly Reader is joining them. So I will link all of their channels down below. They have some great content on middle grade, so definitely go check them out, though I'm sure you're already subscribed. Let's talk about the challenges. So this year, I'm not gonna follow the challenges. I have a ton of books, and I'm fairly confident that at least one of these here will fit the challenges. But I did want to go over them with you just in case you're curious. So the first challenge is to read a book with a silhouette on the cover. The second one is to read a book with strong family elements, which is a lot in middle grade. That should be really easy. The third is a book featuring travel or adventure, which is one of my favorite things to read about in middle grade. Four is a fairy tale retelling or a book that has like fairy tale elements in it. Also something I'm really passionate about, whether it's middle grade, YA, adult, anything fairy tale or mythological or folklore oriented, that's kind of my cup of tea. So if you have any let me know. And also the fifth one is to read a book published in the decade that you were born in. I'm an 80s baby. Everybody was saying how hard it was to find 80s books. And I will agree that there are a lot of like large series out there for younger readers that adults probably aren't super interested in reading. I know I used to have the Babysitter's Club and a lot of R.L. Stein on my shelves when I was a kid. But I actually reordered one a while ago. That was one of my favorites. It was more of the YA age. Maybe I'll do like a books from my childhood video one day. But but I read more R.L. Stein than probably anything else. And I had some other things on my shelves as well. Some Nancy Drew that I think I still have. And some other things. But anyway, I was able to find a couple on my shelves. One is a crossover book, and I'll let you know when we get to that. Now, the group read is The Brave by James Byrd. I entered one of the giveaways, and I was interested in participating, but life has been really crazy right now, and I don't know that reading a book that centers around like an OCD thing would be really what I need right now. I'm sure it's going to be an amazing book, and I hope that many, many people participate. But when I was buying a few new books for this readathon, I figured if I won, it was meant to be and I would participate. But if not, maybe I would hold off on that one for a little while. So let's get into all these books I have. I'm not going to go over specific books for like a specific challenge. I'm just going to tell you the books I have, if I know anything about them, and then as I'm reading during the month, I'll fill them into the challenges they fit in, and then when I do a wrap-up, I'll let you know how I did. The first book that I wanted to include is Baker's Magic, and this is by Diane Zoller, and I have been wanting to read this for a long time, but Food and I have a very strange relationship. Sometimes I really enjoy reading about it, and sometimes it just stresses me out. It's kind of a thing. I have recently been diagnosed with a disease that even more so complicates my relationship with food. But anyway, I digress. Maybe one day I'll get into that. All I really know about this book is that it has to do with like an adventure. I think there's some pirates in here. There's mentions of like bread and baking. And I find sometimes baking to be really cozy. And pirates is a huge buzzword for me. So I picked this up. Plus it's beautiful. And I remember a lot of people were talking about this, I think a couple years ago. And I just haven't had a chance to get to it yet. So I'd like to check this one out. Next is Nancy Farmer's The Sea of Trolls. And I believe this is part of a trilogy. I don't know a lot about this book. All I know is that I think it has to do with the ship. It's like Viking inspired. And I have some Viking history in my family, and so that always intrigues me. Plus, I like adventure historical fiction stories for younger readers. So I picked this one up a long time ago. It's been on my shelves for a while. I think probably because I don't own the other books is one reason why I haven't given it a try. But it's a nice little chunky young fantasy adventure story, so maybe this will be the time to give it a try. Next is one I've tried before, and unfortunately I didn't get through. I get really distracted, too many books. But I was enjoying it, and so I thought maybe I'd give it another try. And this is Martine Leavitt's Keturah and Lord Death, and this has some definite fairy tale elements in it. It's very dark. There's like a wood, and there's a girl, and she's kind of Lord, and she meets Lord Death, and it's about like their interactions and how that affects her life, and it goes on from there. So I'm excited to give this one another try. Next is Ogre Enchanted. This is by Gail Carson Levine. I have previously read I have previously read two of her other books and really enjoyed them, so I'd like to give this one a try. I've heard this is a prequel to her most popular Ella Enchanted, and I've also heard that it has Portuguese roots, and that's really important to me because I'm Portuguese, so there you go. I'm interested in checking this out. And I thought the colors, like the color palette, was really beautiful. So I find this cover really draws me in. So I'm excited to check this one out. Next is another author that has really been on my radar lately. I need to get this sticker off, but this is The Scourge, and this is by Jennifer A. Nielsen. Now, this reminds me of another fairy tale retelling I read, which was by Sophie Jordan, and I believe this is the first book I have here, Reign of Shadows. And this has to do with a girl in a tower as well. I love this duology, by the way. And since this reminded me of that, I thought I would give it a try. Basically, same premise. It's about a girl that is trapped in a tower, and there's basically like a plague type situation happening outside of the tower. Maybe a little sticky for the situation currently, but I really love the other books, so I thought I would give this one a try. Next, I have Undercover Princess by Connie Glynn. And this is a series I've been really wanting to start. I actually ordered book two for this, so I'm trying to like keep the momentum going for series, because if I wait too long, I almost will never finish. So I need to like read them consecutively or close together, because if I stop, I get in this weird like, should I reread the book? Should I just start the next book? Will I remember? Will I not remember? And then I never read the book. So I'm sure you understand. So I don't know a lot about this. I know there's a little bit of mystery involved. I know that there's royalty involved and it's middle grade. Those three things are buzzwords for me. So I picked it up and I'm really excited to give it a try. I have read like the first like paragraph or so of this, and I am so far, and that little snippet that I read, really enjoying the writing style. So I want to give this one a try. Okay, so these are two of my older books that you can tell I've had for a really long time, and these are the two that would fit my decade. So this is Lois Duncan's Locked in Time. This is like the transition book. This is technically more YA, but it says 12-year-olds could read it. So, and I think I bought it at my 7th grade book fair. I could be wrong, but I think so. So I'm gonna consider this middle grade, because I would have been reading this kind of stuff at that age. And also After the Dancing Days, this is by Margaret I. Rostowski, and this has to do, I believe, with it's World War I. I couldn't remember if it was one or two, but it's World War I. And I think the girl's father gets injured, and it's about how that affects the rest of her life. So, in their family and all the after effects of the war. So I don't normally like to read war books, but I had it on my shelves. I never read it. I've had them for a really long time. So I thought maybe I would give these a try for that challenge. And then I also picked up the first three books in the Enola Holmes mystery series. So this is book one, The Case of the Missing Marquess. This is book two. This is Left-Handed Lady. And book three, The Case of the Bizarre Bouquets. I know that Netflix put out a movie on this. We don't really do Netflix anymore, but it looked really good. And I want to read the series first. And I read kind of, again, like sometimes I'll read just the first few sentences to see if I like the writing style. And it kind of clicked with me. And these are really quick reads. I think there are six in the series right now, and I picked up the first three. So I'm hoping to get to these. Plus like Cat Silhouette. I'm totally counting that. Okay, so I'm sorry like with all the movement and stuff today, but I really wanted to give you a shot in my shelves. So hopefully this works out okay. Okay. This is a book that was really popular a few years ago, I think. This is The School for Good and Evil by Soman Chanani. And I've ordered the second book of this one as well. These are nice chunky middle grades. They're fantasy. They have to do with like that fairy tale element. There's a boarding school. These are all things I love. I'm really excited for this. I'm hoping that I love it as much as the reviews online seem to say. And my light's changing again, but I haven't been able to film in like 3 weeks because my daughter's nap schedule has changed. So hopefully you can still see me. I've also ordered the second book to this series. This is The Stormkeeper's Island by Catherine Doyle. And I don't know a lot about this, but I think there's some mystery elements involved, and it's set on an island, and it's middle grade adventure. That's pretty much all I needed to know. I'm looking forward to this. I've heard good things. So yeah, here's another one that I might get to. Okay, this was a previous group book for middle grade March, and I never got a chance to get to it, so I thought maybe I would this time. This is by Jonathan Oxier, and this is Sweep, the story of a girl and her monster. From what I know, this talks about the chimney sweeps and the dangerous life they led, and there's some magic involved and a golem, and it sounds really lovely. I've heard really good things, and yeah, it's about time I got to this one. Next is Dragon Pearl. This is a Rick Riordan Presents. This is by Yoon Han Lee. And yeah, I've been meaning to read this book for way too long. I need to just get to it. It's like a middle grade space opera. Do you need more? I didn't. This is also a previous group book. I didn't buy it for that, but I had heard really great things about it. Here's the Newbery medal here. This is The Girl Who Drank the Moon by Kelly Barnhill. I've been wanting to read this for a long time. Witches, woods, middle grade, again, buzzwords, sounds amazing. This is The Book of the Maidservant, and this is by Rebecca Barnhouse. Now this, you can see the little sticker. So in Florida, which is where I live, when you drive north on Florida, there's all these signs for this like book warehouse. I had never been. I had seen them for years. One day I finally stopped and I happened to find this there. I haven't heard a lot about this. I know it's a middle grade historical fiction, and you don't see them a lot. It was $2. It seemed like a good idea. And it's just beautiful just in itself. I think it's a beautifully published book. I've read some of the first sentences again on this, and I enjoyed it, and I've been thinking about it, so maybe I'll give this one a try. This is a new one I picked up for this year. This is One Jar of Magic by Corey Ann Haidu, and I read, again, the first like page or so of this online before I purchased it, and I loved the writing style. I loved kind of the flow of the story. Seems like this is going to be very magical, but also with like a lot of family elements, and I'm really excited to read this one. Yeah, so had to have it, and I'm really excited for it. Next is one that was a gift from my mom. Thanks, Mom! This is A Most Magical Girl, and this is by Karen Foxley. She's also author of Ophelia and the Marvelous Boy, which I had heard of. I hadn't heard of this book before. It mentions magic. There's a wood right on the front and a wand. Again, buzzwords is usually how I buy middle grades, and I'll read a couple of the first sentences, and this was a gift, so good job, Mom. I mean, buzzwords accounted for. yeah, it's beautiful, and I'm excited to give it a try. Okay, here is another one that I picked up for the readathon this year. This is Cinders and Sparrow. This is by Stefan Bachman, and this one feels very Narnia to me, like just reading the description. There's a letter that she receives, and she gets pulled into this magical world, and there's some definite dark elements in this. I think there's a crow, and it just feels really magical. It also feels very Wizard of Oz to me, which is one of my favorite children's classics and also one of my favorite movies as a child. So yeah, so I really just want to give this a try. Even though it almost looks a little bit like the Emerald City. So we'll see how this goes, but yeah, I'm really excited for this one. Next is another one I also picked up for this readathon. This is Eva Evergreen, The Semi-Magical Witch by Julie Abe. And this sounds so sweet. This sounds like a big hug. I believe it's a duology, and I think the second book is coming out soon. This just seems really sweet, like a young girl who goes to witch school, and there's like pets and animals involved. And I read again the first couple of sentences. It just seems like it's gonna be a big warm hug from what I've seen, and I'm really excited for this one. Here's another book by Julie Berry, who I really enjoy. This is The Emperor's Ostrich. I've been meaning to get to some more of her books, and yeah, I think I found this at our dollar store, which is crazy, and it was her, so I bought it. It's like a children's journey story, which I love journeys, and there's an ostrich and a cow on the cover. It's all I needed to know. All right, now I've put some classics on my shelves, some children's classics, because I do really enjoy reading classics. Of course, this is The Hobbit by J.R.R. Tolkien. I've seen the movies, never read the books, but I do own this one, and it's a horrible copy. It's very hobbitish, which is just my size. So I'm excited to read this one. I'm sure you all know what it's about. Journey. It's me. I like it. So maybe I'll give this one a try. I also have here, this is Kenneth Graham's The Wind and the Willows. I've been wanting to read this. I have been in a real mood for stories narrated by animals. It's a thing. I'm into it. And I think on Disney Plus, my family and I found like an old cartoon that had some of these characters in it. And it has kind of just spawned my love for those characters. And when my husband and I went to Disneyland years ago, we got to ride Mr. Toad's ride again, which was lovely because they don't have it here in Florida anymore. I know people are still upset about it, but I think it might be time. Okay, now I have one by E. Nesbitt. This is The Enchanted Castle. Honestly, it was a cover buy. I knew the author, I saw the cover, I bought it. I've had it for a while. I picked this up when I started, after my daughter was born, I was gonna do like a bedtime story edition on my channel, and I do still plan on doing that, but I never finished Anne, and I need to finish Anne with an E. I know, wait. It's here. I read both The Secret Garden and Black Beauty before I had my daughter, and then I tried reading this to her when she was little, and she was just too small for it. She wasn't interested in it, and I just couldn't get through it. Even as a baby, like, she just, I don't know. Usually I could read her anything and it would be fine, but I just wasn't able to get through it. And so I thought, I'll just put it aside for a while and I'll go back to it. And here it is. So I think that's enough books to be getting to, but if it's not, I have more. I mean, there's more over here, there's more up here. Those are just the ones I wanted to talk to you about today. My video is gone on forever now, but I love Middle Grade March. Thank you so much for hosting it. I really am in the mood to just read some light fantasy, adventure, family books. I want some really feel good, help me love myself, help me love the world books. It's just the mood I'm in, and I think middle grade is perfect for that. So recently I read a really gory, not so much book, and I think it's put me in the mood to just read all the light and fluffy things. So that's what I'm looking for. So yeah, if you have any middle grade adventure, fantasy, fairy tale, family-oriented recommendations that you'd like to share below, I would love to see them. I do enjoy reading middle grade, and you will almost always find at least one on my end of the year wrap-up. It is not like the primary age group that I read from, but I do really enjoy it when I do, so you will see some of it on my channel here. So anyway, I hope there goes my light again. So that's everything I have for you today. I have missed filming. I've missed you all. Change in family, stay-at-home mom schedules, they happen, but I'm still here. So thank you if you're new. I would love if you would subscribe. It means a lot to me. If you're returning, thank you very much. I hope that everyone has been taking care of themselves in our changing world and being good to themselves. You don't need a reason to celebrate yourself. So just know that every day is a reason to be thankful and grateful and good to yourself. But I hope that you're all well. I thank you so much for being here with me today. Farewell for now. Bye-bye.